Greetings and salutations, everyone. It's been a while. I have no excuse. Not a good one, anyway. Not one worthy of Valhalla. Or the path to Valhalla, the Valheim. I do have to let you know this, though. Where I'm currently living, I don't have much in the way of internet. Haven't for a few years. I get potential access to internet every 3 to 6 months, but that doesn't always happen. With that being said, this game was recommended to me by so many of my friends, and it was also gifted to me. Thank you very much for that person. That I played this, and they wanted to know my feet. They just wanted to know what I thought of the game. They thought it was absolutely amazing. This is probably the most recommended and requested game from my friends for me to play as a single-player game for some time. And so, with everyone else playing this, I figured, why not me too? You know, I can do this from the comfort of my own home. Now, I do want to let you know up front, these videos will be recorded on my computer, and then we'll be taking them and transferring them to my phone, and then from my phone they'll be uploaded to the internet, which is hopefully working. If you're seeing this video, it worked. Yay. If not, then boohoo. But I just got a new phone not that long ago, so hopefully the new phone can handle this. But yeah, let's get started. I've only played enough to get familiar with the controls and try to do something with a little bit of the audio and stuff like that. It's been a long time since I've recorded. It's going to feel weird getting back in the saddle with this. But hopefully you're along with the ride with me. And we can see what we got going on. And for everyone who wanted to see me play this, here you go. Thank you very much. You get my raw, unfiltered opinion about what's going on. I'm going to be reading a lot of stuff. In different weird voices. Get used to it. And you probably won't see this changelog update very often. And if it does, I will definitely be letting you know. So, first and foremost, this game is early access and still in development. However, from what I've played, it is an exception to that slanderous title of being early access. This is a good game so far. I hope they don't screw it up. But let's go and get started. We got Dino the Beano here. He's a good little lad. He's ready to go into the world. He's got a bit of a man bun back there, but you know, that's ergonomical. You need that. Actually, ergonomical's probably not the right word in the usage of needing a ponytail. Anyway, so, but yeah. This is such a good game. So the game is based on, if you don't know, the game is based on Viking mythology. And it is so good. So let's get started. If you want to play along with me, that is the world that I named, and that is the seed. Or if you don't want to play along with it, you just want to check out the world for yourself, maybe point some stuff out that I missed or anything like that. There you go. So, apparently each world is procedurally generated. It's really awesome. Let's get to the good stuff, huh? Long ago, the All-Father Odin united the worlds. He threw down his foes and cast them into the 10th world, then split the boughs that held their prison to the world tree and left it to drift, unanchored, a place of exile. For centuries, this world slumbered uneasily. But it did not die. As glacial ages passed, kingdoms rose and fell out of sight of the gods. When Odin heard his enemies were growing once again in strength, he looked to Midgard and sent his Valkyries to scour the battlefields for the greatest of their warriors. Dead to the world, they would be born again in Valheim. And that is what we are. That's what you play as. We play as a fallen Viking warrior, or someone who's died in combat of the Scandinavian culture, and look a little awkward being held in spread eagle nice lightning bolt in the claws of a Valkyrie raven. very good rendition of an actual Valkyrie, though. Terrifying. Ooh, that's probably a... Yeah, we'll see that in the sky in a second when it's daytime. But yeah. Oh man, here we go. Ooh, right here on the beach. This is different from the last one. Oh, this one's a little bit more ominous. This is a cool spot. Alright. I say last one because I started a world real quick just to see if the... whatchamacallit, the controls worked and everything for me. And everything's working fine. Oh, man. Okay, so let's go and get over what I already know first before we talk to old Hugin here. Hugin's our friend and our pal, eh? Oh, the fog is nice. I love it. All right, so these runes signify, from what I can gather, what I can guess, they signify bosses. Okay? So I think this is our first one, Aethkir. Vegsvir Aethkir, and we'll read each one as it begins to glow, or we'll read that one, and then we'll read the one glowing, and then we'll read the one that we have to go to next. But as you can see, by scale, for the most part, there is an order we have to do these in. So arrival is what I'm guessing this one is, because this matches with that. Then the stag, and I'm not sure if this is an int or a drow, or maybe, I'm not quite sure. I don't remember exactly what creature that could be. It could be a giant, but this looks more like giant to me, but I don't know. Who knows? And then this is either a giant or an elemental. I'm assuming giant. Maybe thinking about it, it might be a dwarf. I didn't even think about that. It might be a dwarf and that would be a giant. That would make sense because this one's all short and chunky. And then we've got the dragon with the morning sun. Oh, that looks so good. That's such a good image. And then we have Manamarco, the king of worms. I don't have a better way to describe him than that. Alright, what you need, Hugin?
I am Hugin, sent here to guide you on your travels. The megaliths surrounding you are the sacrificial stones. They represent the Forsaken, which you must slay in order to ascend to Valhalla.
Thanks. So it's your standard survival game. I already know to pick up everything you possibly can at first. So we're going to do this before we keep talking to Hugin.
These magical stones were scattered throughout the lands by Odin.
He's talking about these standing rune stones.
As signposts pointing towards the ritual grounds of the Forsaken. If inspected closer, this one will reveal the summoning place of Aethkir, your first prey. He is a mighty beast, so you need to properly arm yourself before even attempting to defeat him.
Oh, okay. Alright. You grabbed Midgard's mightiest dead warrior. So, you know. Alright, let's read this. Oh, reading it. I forgot. Reading it just points to it on the... Oh, it's like right there. Oh, that's... Okay. Alright. That's cool. And then... This is about Aethkir, I think. His antlers are branches of iron. They crack the rocks and bring down mountains. His hooves are the sound of thunder. His voice, a howling gale. And that right there is about as far as I got before I was like, okay, I need to record this. Is this a stone? Yes, it is. Thank you very much.
What is that thing?
Alright, hold on. Before we get started, let's get enough to be able to get a tool. Oh, God. Is that enough? That's enough for that. Let's try that. That's a different material. Okay, interesting. Let's see, what do we got here? For an axe, what do I need? Oh my gosh, needs more wood. What you got here?
Most items must be crafted. However, due to your recent departure from Midgard, you will have to recall the true shape of objects. Just pick things up and it will come back to you, I'm sure. My lesser brother, Munin, tells me one can fashion a stone axe out of wood and stone.
I wouldn't have been able to figure that by the name Stone Axe. Thank you. Thank you so much, Hugin. What is... Alright, let's go check this thing out. What is this thing? Hey, ooh. Hey, little buddy. I'm not after you. I'm just wanting to check on you. What's going on? Hey, whoa, 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 whoa. Hey.
Yeah.
There we go. I didn't want to do that. Ooh. A trophy and a tail. A neck tail. Neck tail. Alright. Let's gather these stones real quick. That's another neck tail thing over there. And all of this. Oh, that's a berry bushes. Come on. Let me get some wood here. Okay. Can I craft this now? Thank you. There we go. Now I got something to defend myself with. Whoa, what are you? Yeah, get out of here. Ow! Ow! Oh my gosh. Graylings. Okay. Alright. It's got these things just roaming around out here, I see. Huh. One of the boughs holding us to Midgard that has been cut free. Gotta wonder how Odin and them are able to get back over here if they cut us free from the life tree. Something up there? Oh yes, there is. Feathers, amber, and coins. Alright. Now we already know that this world used to have empires, right? Shouldn't I be able to just rip that apart? No? Can rip that apart, yeah? No. Okay. Anyway, we already know that this place, this world used to have empires. That's what they said in the intro. So we'll find these ruins, I guess, all over the place. Oh, hey, Hugin. I was about to go attack you.
With this tool, you'll raise mighty halls, towering fortifications. Start by building a workbench. This, in turn, will enable you to construct many other things.
Oh, he's talking about the hammer. Yeah. Thank you, Hugin. You are dismissed. Alright. A little bit of deadfall here. Ooh, mushrooms. Mushroom? Yep, that is a mushroom. Sweet. Thank you, Minecraft, for having me recognize... Ooh. Oh, the deer make weird noises here. They have a weird bark to them. What you got for me, Hugin? Hey, maybe not so close to the, is that a boar? Oh.
You have found a snack. Consume it to improve your health and stamina. But beware. Before long, you will grow hungry again, so try to always have at least a couple different meals ready.
Oh, thank you. Did I forget how to live when I died? That would make sense, but...
Ow.
There we go. Take that. Sweet. Oop. Let's cut all this down right here. I have a feeling we're going to need a ton of wood. In fact, I'll be right back after we chop a whole bunch of this stuff down. Here we go. Here we go. This tree should be the last tree we need. Oh! Watch out! That's fallen. Oh, they fall! Like, they fall. Now that's cool. I was kind of hoping this would fall with it. I guess that needs that tree gone to finish falling. Can I... Oh, a little bit too hard. Okay. Let's get this going. There we go. There we go. What is it? Oh. Buzz off, guy. Not you again. Yeah! Alright, you know, I'm kind of liking, kind of like right where we're at. It's not a bad little spot, to be honest. Oh, there goes the axe. Get that unarmed skill up. Learn how to punch a man. Yeah, kind of like this little spot. Got the deer right there. I don't know if animals respawn if you kill them. We don't have a way of means of killing the deer just yet anyway, but I kind of like this. Kind of overlooks this a little bit. This looks nice. Oh, there's another island like right there within... Yeah, we're setting up shop here. This is a cool spot. All right, let's clear the area a little bit more. How much wood do we have? I feel like we're going to need a little bit more than that. Let's get... I just got a gut feeling. A lot of these survival games take a lot of crafting bit first until you get better. Wait, is crafting even a skill? Aren't there skills in this game? There we go. Crafting is not a skill. Okay, well then maybe not then. Alright. Yeah, it's really close to that ruin too. We got this big boulder here. Yeah, this is a great spot. This is an amazing spot. Yeah, we're set up here. Yeah. Alright. Three. Workbench. Middle mouse wheel to rotate. M3 to remove? I'm assuming M3 is press the middle mouse wheel. Yeah, then left click to place. Flint, axe, a hoe, all kinds of stuff. Ooh, all kinds of stuff. Look. Hey, Hugin!
The workbench allows you to craft complex items, as well as giving you access to lots more building pieces to construct with the hammer.
Cool. Thanks for that, Hugin. Okay, so do you need... Probably, yeah, you need that. You need that for something. What is this for? It's a chopping block. It's got a little star next to it. I have no idea. Maybe I don't have enough stones? Let's go look for more stones. Mean little beastie. Oh, there's another one. Right. Oh. Oh, they do go after you. I thought they didn't go after you. Okay. I'm warning you, I know Kung Fu! Oh! Oh, okay. I guess I did know Kung Fu. Alright. I don't know why I'm building this chopping block thing. I just feel like maybe it can help me use the wood more. More effectively. You know, it's a chopping block. It's got a stone axe into a block of wood. Or into a stump of wood. I feel that's the image. I just feel like it would be useful for the hell was that anyway. Ooh. Is that a mountain or is that just part of the background? Oh man, we've gotta be on like a giant lake or something, right? That looks awesome. Let's clip more of the shiny rocks. Ooh! Whoa! Is tide a thing in this game? Or is that just a big wave? I'm assuming that's just a big wave. Okay. Look for more of the shiny rocks. How many does that put us at? 10. Let's grab a few more. I feel like we're gonna need them. Because you're not gonna put two types of stone resources and not have it, and have this be just for one thing. You know what I mean? Who does that? That's kind of ridiculous. Get that run skill up, yo. Ooh, oh yeah! Swim, swim. Alright. Getting a little far from the house. The sun's starting to go down. Let's get back home. Alright. Where were we? Getting a little dark now. Yeah, there we go. Now we can craft one of these. I'll just put it right next to it here. Okay, that's cool. Alright, and needs a roof. Okay. Building. Oh, just kind of snaps. It's cool, I like it. Feels like it feels kind of standard nowadays, but I like it all the same. What's this white dot thing off in the distance? Is that just a radius of this thing? Surely. It'd be kind of weird if it wasn't. Let's hope this qualifies as a roof. This little lean-to here. Does that work for a roof for you? Too exposed. Okay. Music changed. I'm a big fan of that. Half wall? Nah, let's do full wall. What the hell? Oh, it's Hugin. Alright. We'll get to you in a second, but I want to go ahead and get this going. Alright. Do I get resources back? Okay, yeah, you do get resources back. Good. Whew. How about now? Too exposed? No. Okay, awesome. Let's craft what we can. Sharper than stone axe. Well, stone axe is broken, so let's go ahead and craft that up. Is there a way to repair these, or is that just going to be a useless item in my inventory now? Let's craft a hoe. I've already got a torch. I don't have a bow. I don't have a way to make a bow, according to this. Got a weapon. At least we can defend ourselves a little bit better than barehanded. Even though we're doing pretty good barehanded so far. What you got for me, Hugh?
When the temperature drops at night, or if you are wet, you will suffer from being cold. This reduces your stamina regeneration.
Regeneration? Wow, Hugin, it's amazing English you've got there.
Shut up. Seeking shelter by open flame is the best option when this happens.
Okay. Alright, well, what's the... Thanks. What? Why didn't you just pop up over here a while ago? Oh, whatever, Hugin. Oh, something about the hoe.
This tool was used for
Is that what it used for? I wouldn't have used a hoe for landscaping, but okay.
Still used for landscaping. You can say it's the perfect complement to the hammer. You can use it to clear the ground and manipulate the terrain. It is easier to create buildings on level ground.
Thank you, Hugin. Okay, well, I would not have made a hoe for that. I was thinking make a hoe for, seeds, maybe something, figuring out somehow to replant mushrooms. Maybe those berry bushes down there, whatever. Doesn't matter. Can I chop this down now? Too hard. That pig just running around down there? Are you coming after me, pig? Because I will gut you. That's what I thought. Alright, well, Hugin did basically just tell us this grass will not go away unless we level everything out. So let's get to level. Oh, you have to click on it. Ooh. Okay. Alright. Nice to have just kind of a left hold. Left click and hold, but is what it is. Not gonna complain too much. Yeah, you know, I kind of like the character of the birch, the fallen birch, just kind of leaning against his compatriot there. We're gonna keep that there, I think. Also, that is difficult to climb up. Okay. Is that even? It's kind of hard to tell at night. There we go. Let's even this out a little bit more. I think that might be as even as the game wants me to be. Kind of a sunken in bit there. Whatever. Alright. No. Alright. Well, that's cool. Don't know what else to say to that. What do we got? Is it like a foundation? Floor, 1x1 floor, and 2x2 floor. So, well, say 1x1, 2x2, what are we dealing with in scale? I'm gonna say the average Viking warrior, 6 foot. So roughly 2 meters. So that would put this at 2x2, or 6 foot by 6 foot, right? You would think. So that's 18, 24 feet. That's what that is. Okay. You know what this could be? This could be the fire pit. Right here. Yeah, there we go. Now you're thinking with brains, Zach. This will be the fire pit of the house right here. I wonder if you can build up like an actual fireplace. That stone just gonna be in the floor of my house. Okay, that's just in the ground. Maybe we could put the fireplace on the dirt. Try to make it look like that was intentional to add that to my house. So I'm thinking front door, like porch right here, right? Just kind of walking you through my idea. And then house. Nothing special, nothing fancy, just, yeah. All right, let's get to building a wall. Go. I'm assuming I'm building this right side in, because I would want the supports to be visible on the inside of the house. Mostly just because I don't want someone coming up to the side ripping off this postal here. This support beam here and ruining my day. Go. The front door seems right up there. There we go. Perfect. How much wood do we have left? Oh, yeah, that ate a lot into the wood. I was afraid of that. Uh, Can I at least craft a fire? That only takes 2 wood. Okay. Yeah, we can craft a fire. Oh, I couldn't even put the... Okay, so I couldn't put the fire on the wood floor anyway. That makes total sense. I wonder if you can get an upgraded fireplace later. Put you right here. Is that a fairly clear spot to the sky? Not really, but... Oop. Lag spike. Anyway, not really. But maybe we could put like a flue that directs the smoke different direction. Let's see here. Alright. Put that right there. That'll work. Furniture. This all needs more wood. Everything needs more wood. Alright, it looks like we're going to be clear-cutting the forest around us for a little while. Oh, I wonder if I can reclaim my little shack here. 2 wood, 4 wood, 6 wood, 8 wood, 10 wood, 12 wood, 22 wood. Okay. So now we can at least build a door. Oh, it needs a workbench. That's right. Ooh, kind of cramped. That's okay. Workbench right. Yeah, that's kind of cool. You can merge it into the structure a little bit. It hides it a little bit better. Makes it look it's a little bit more built in, so to speak. So I'm assuming it hinges out that way. Want that? Yeah, I want that, because I want to be able to open that door and see that beautiful ocean view. Hey, we got a door! Alright, well, I think that's a good place to stop for the first little bit here. I'm going to go cut down a whole bunch of more trees, and we'll come back to that and see how things are going. But yeah, I hope you're digging it. I hope you're liking it. I certainly am so far, and hopefully on this journey with me, we'll get things going pretty good.